Bilharziosis of cispermatic cord and epididymis. This is a common disease in endemic areas like Egypt. Usually there are two types of Bilharziosis: Schistosoma hematobium and Schistosoma mansoni. Schistosoma hematobium is the urinary Bilharziosis, lives in the veins around the renal bladder and prostate, in the perivesical and periprostatic venous plexus. Severe Schistosoma hematobium, which is urinary Bilharziosis, is the commonest cause for Bilharziosis in the scrotum. Why? From the veins around the urinary bladder and the prostate, these veins anastomose with the veins around the vas. Therefore, the adult worms lives in the perivesical and periprostatic venous plexus, pass through anastomosis to the veins around the vas, migrate against the blood flow from above downward to the veins around the vas to the bambini-form plexus to reach the very small venules. Small venules of the bambini-form plexus in the lower part of the spermatic cord and the head of epididymis. There is rare cause for Bilharziosis in the scrotum, which is Schistosoma mansoni. Schistosoma mansoni lives in the inferior mesenteric vein and its tributary. The inferior mesenteric vein here on the left side runs here, not present in the picture, but it runs here, retroperitoneal on the posterior abdominal wall. The inferior mesenteric vein anastomose with this vein. What is this vein? Left testicular vein. And if Schistosoma mansoni migrate to the left testicular vein, it migrate against the blood flow to reach the very small venules in the bambini-form plexus and start to lay over, and the ova bears the venular wall to reach around the veins, where the ova around the vein excite immune reaction, forming Bilharzial granuloma. Therefore, the cause is usually severe Schistosoma hematobium, lives around the urinary bladder and the prostate, and through anastomosis it passes to the veins around the vas, which anastomose with the bambini-form plexus to reach the very small venules, or rarely on the left side. Schistosoma mansoni from inferior mesenteric vein, which anastomose with the left testicular vein, migrate against the blood flow to reach the very small venules of the bambini-form plexus. And you should notice that the small venules of the bambini-form plexus lies here in the lower part of the spermatic cord and head of epididymis, where the ova bears the venous wall, excite granuloma formation leading to perivenous Bilharzial granuloma. The granuloma may be very small, fine granuloma. In case of very small, fine granuloma, this type is called granular type, like very small, fine granules in the lower part of the spermatic cord and the head of epididymis. This is called the granular type. Bilharzial granuloma may be large, forming nodules, one or more nodule. This is called the nodular type. One or more nodule of Bilharzia granuloma, and this is the commonest type. And it's this nodule is characteristic in the lower part of the spinal cord and head of epididymis, the site of very fine venules where the ova is deposited and bears the venous wall, forming the Bilharzia granuloma. Very, very rarely there may be a massive Bilharzia granuloma, including inside the granuloma, the lower part of the spermatic cord, epididymis, and the testis. This is called the massive type. It is very rare, but it is a very important differential diagnosis with testicular tumor. Differentiation is very, very difficult. What is the clinical picture? General examination may show hepatosplenomegaly and ascites as a manifestation of Bilharzia. BR examination may show Bilharzia of the prostate and the seminal vesicles. Local examination. As usual, there may be pain. Pain is dull aching or dragging pain. There is scrotal swelling. The scrotal swelling is usually firm, slowly growing in the characteristic site, lower part of spermatic cord and head of epididymis. And as usual, there may be secondary lax hydrocele. Investigation, urine and stool analysis will show the Bilharzia ova. Treatment, mainly conservative, anti-Bilharzia drugs. Surgical treatment, if there is severe pain or suspicious for malignancy. What is the treatment? Excision of the nodule for biopsy with preservation of the important structure, preservation of the vase, testis, epididymis, and testicular vessels. Therefore, excision of the nodule without affection of testicular vessels, testis, vase, epididymis. This is Bilharzia of the spermatic cord. Thank you for good listening and good luck.